नमो तस्से भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्से। नमो तस्से भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्से। नमो तस्से भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्से। ओके, we are still continues the Mahaparinibbana Sutta. Actually, that sutta explaining another there are seven conditions, as long as there are these seven conditions enter among the bhikkhu must practice. What are the another seven conditions? Actually, those are seven conditions are we call the seven bojjhanga, the seven enlightenment factors, satta bojjhanga, enlightenment factors. So what are the seven? The Lord Buddha mentioned yavakivancha bhikkhave bhikkhu sati sambojjhangam bhavissanti. Monks, as long as the monks develop mindfulness as the factor of enlightenment factor. Dhamma-vicca-sambojjhangam-bhavissanti. Analyzing of qualities as a factor for enlightenment factor. Actually, this is we call the like panya, wisdom. Next one we call virya, the energy factor of enlightenment. This is piti sambojjhangam bhaveti rapture as the factor of the enlightenment. Next one passaddi, calm as a factor for enlightenment. Actually, calm means the tranquility. Samadhi sambojjhangam bhavissanti, concentration as a factor for enlightenment. Enlightenment. Upekkha sambojjhangam bhaveti, equanimity as a factor for enlightenment. There are seven enlightenment factors. Now we want to know the meaning deeply, because those are factors very important for us to develop our concentration. Because if someone want to develop their concentration, especially the jhana-appana, absorbed concentration, you must balance your jhana mind, concentration mind with the eight enlightenment factors. Without developing enlightenment factors, without knowing enlightenment factors, difficult to develop your concentration, difficult to develop your wisdom. The if someone want to realize the Nibbana, then the everyone must know clearly about the enlightenment factors. That's why we are going to explain one by one deeply. This one also important for us to know about the meaning of the each factor, and we can develop the each factors individually, and we can the after practicing we can increase our the Dhamma quality, the good qualities in our life. Actually, now the one example, now you know the about the nutriment, the food. The food very important for us to maintain our physical body. Without food, difficult to maintain, difficult to survive. The same way, they need some food for the mind to maintain. This way, we have to understand for the enlightenment factors also need the food, need the nutrients conditions. Without the food, also difficult to develop those are conditions, the enlightenment factors. So now we are going to explain which kind of food support to each factor and which kind of the condition support to each factors. This way we are going to explain. In the first one, we call the mind, the sati sambodjanga, enlightenment factor of mindfulness. Now we know about the mindfulness, very important. Mindfulness is this mindfully, you have to practice everything with mindfully. And the without example, now you see who the Lord Buddha mentioned, if someone want to develop the meditation, his mindfulness very weak, so difficult to practice meditation. Now if someone want to develop your own concentration, we must need the mindfulness. Without the mindfully, we cannot develop our concentration and our everything, we cannot develop. That's why the frequent wise attention to things that are the basic for the enlightenment factors of mindfulness. Now yoniso manasikara, wise attention, right wise attention is a very the important. The wise attention is the means the wise attention is the main things, main base to develop our enlightenment factor of the mindfulness. And that's why the Lord Buddha mentioned the yonisocha bhikkave manasikaroto anupanna cheva kusala dhamma uppajjanti. Because of wise attention, unarisen wholesome to arise. And now always unarisen wholesome to arise is the all support the wise attention. Ayonisocha bhikkave manasikaroto anupannacha akusala dhamma uppajjanti. Now because of unwise attention, unarisen unwholesome to arise. Now this way we have to understand wise attention, yoniso manasikara, always the main condition to develop our mindfulness enlightenment factor. What is the why the mindfulness the factor very important for us, especially the we are meditators, the we want to practice satipatthana, the four foundation of mindfulness. This is the object of the mindfulness. Now everyone can think what is the object of the mindfulness. Now especially four foundations of mindfulness, there are four methods: kayanupassana, vedananupassana, cittanupassana, dhammanupassana, the contemplating of the physical body, contemplating of the feeling, contemplating of the citta and the consciousness, and contemplating of the dhamma formation. Now this way we need strong mindfulness to practice and to develop these four foundation method. The same way the bodhipakkhya, now the bodhipakkhya is there are 37 factors of enlightenment, very important, because now total. Now today we are going to explore only seven enlightenment factors, but actually all together there are 37 enlightenment factors. Every the bodhisattva and who want to realize the nibbana, everyone must practice those are the 37 enlightenment factors. Actually the namely briefly I can explain about four satipatthana and four sammapadhana, for energetic the knowledge, the avidya, and the 4 iddipada and the 5 faculties, 5 energy and 7 bojanga and 8 fold path. Those are great qualities we have to develop every mind moment. Example, when we are offering dana for the Buddha, when you are offering flowers or incense stick, water, whatever good thing to the Buddha or Sangha, they all the time arising wholesome mind. Those are wholesome mind always associating those are 37 factors among maybe the sum of the factors. But anyway, the if you know the meaning of the 37 factors of enlightenment, this one also very helpful for us to develop wholesome and develop our good mind. Another thing, the what's the object of the mindfulness? There are 9 supramundane dhamma. Now, what are the 9 supramundane dhamma? Actually, they are the Sotapatti Magga Pala, Sakadagami Magga Pala, Anagami Magga Pala, Arahatta Magga Pala, and Nibbana. Those are 9 is a Lokuttara Dhamma. This is a object of the mindfulness. Now, this way we have to increase our practice. Another thing, there are other 4 conditions to develop, to arise our the mindfulness, allied factors of mindfulness. What are the 4? Mindfulness and clear comprehensions is all activities. Sati sampajanya. Now the sati is a mindfulness and sampajanya is a clear comprehensions. Means there are 4 types of sampajanya. Now there actually is not mentioned the 4 types of clear comprehension, the 4 sampajanya. Satak purpose and sapphire suitability and the gochara field or domain and asammoha non-delusion. Actually, those are 4 sampajanya. How we develop now, they are explained the commentary, there are lot of the explanation, but briefly we can try to get the meaning about the sattaka purpose. When we are going to do something, you have to always think this one good or bad, this one the meaningful or not. Always try to understand clear. This is what we call sattaka. This is sattaka. And sappa is suitable. I am monk. I am the good donor. I am the always the I am the good upasaka. I am the good upasika. So the I like this. I am the good. This one suitable or not for me to do. Example now, who want to practice dhamma diligently? Those are people. They are not interested to join the big event for the big event because during that moment very easy to the get the restlessness of our life and very easy to the arise the many kind of defilements. So because of that, some people doesn't like to involve to the big event or others' problem or other society. They want to stay separate. They want to stay alone. They want to practice Dhamma alone. This way we can understand about the sappaya and asappaya, suitability and unsuitability. And the gochara is very important. Because why? Gochara is a field. When we are going to, example, bhikkhua, bhikkhu going to alms round and they return back to the monastery. They are going and coming. the both are, you should do it mindfully. When you start to go pindapata, always you try to keep you go with mindfully. Don't look at around and don't talk with the people and don't laugh and don't do any misbehavior during that period. Then you should carry on your own meditation object. It's very important. You have to bring your meditation object. It's very important. Without the your meditation object, if you fall down during the pindapatha time, it is not nice. That's why we call the Pali gata pachagata vata. He is going pindapatha with the meditation object and return back also with the meditation object. We call gochara sampajanya. Another one is non-delusion, asammoha. Asammoha means whatever you are taking, whatever you are using, whatever you are doing, everything you should do with understanding mind. Example, now we are bhikkhu, we can accept the four allowable requisite from the people. When we are using those allowable requisite all the time, we have to understand these properties look like very nice, but all are material things, but all are elements, patavyapo tejo vayu, and I am also this body, also physical body, not the this non-self, and after we using this one, maybe soul is destroying, and this way you have to keep the vipassana knowledge. That we always try to keep the vipassana mind when we are taking whatever you are taking. Then this is important for the gochara sampajanya. And another thing, this way the mindfulness you can establish according to the sati sampajanya. Always you try to stay with mindfulness awareness, very important to us. The number two, the avoiding unmindful people. You should try to understand after associating the people, you can see according to his behavior, his understanding and others' understanding, he's practicing mindfulness or not. This way, if someone not developing mindfulness, not practicing mindfulness, they don't interest to meditate, they are not interested to develop dhamma, those are people you should avoid from your life. It is very important to develop your mindfulness and associating with mindful people. You should try to engage or try to associate the mindful people, because some people very much like to meditate, very much like to develop dhamma and practice dhamma and teach the dhamma. Then when you are associating those people, then automatically the mind arising, oh, I also want to develop my mindfulness, I also want to develop my mindfulness. This way you're always keeping your good strong mind. This way that you should try to associate with who has mindfulness. In this is number four, third. Number fourth we call tadidimuttata is a right resolution. Actually this one but English meaning the resolution, actually the my understanding tadidimuttata means the to establishing of mindfulness to develop this. I because He has my, I want to do, I want to do, I want to develop, I want to develop, I want to get the this one. This way, the means that slants or maybe slopes or and inclines towards the establishing of mindfulness, because he has wish, I want to develop mindfulness. I have the wish, I want to get the experience of mindfulness. This is a meaning, right? Resolution. This is English. Okay. This way, the you know about the enlightenment factor of the mindfulness. This one also very important. Okay. Number two, enlightenment factor of Dhamma Vichaya. Investigation of Dhamma. Now, actually the Dhamma is a phenomena. Dhamma is a phenomena. Investigating. Now, you want to penetrate the Dhamma. Means this is wisdom. Because actually, without the wisdom, we cannot penetrate. We cannot investigate anything. Now, the second factor is a wisdom factor. Investigation of the Dhamma means enlightenment factor of the investigation factor. Now, the frequently giving wise attention to a wholesome and unwholesome state. This one also the always the have always arising with the Yoniso Manasikara, wise attention. Who has wise attention? Yoniso Manasikara. Because of the Yoniso Manasikara, he can understand clearly what is the wholesome state, what is the unwholesome state. Because we want to divide wholesome and unwholesome. Who has wisdom? He can divide by himself. He can understand clearly what is the wholesome, what is the unwholesome. The same way, the blameful and blameless. Now, the blameful and blameless, because the when you are commit evil, akusala, when you are doing the evil thing, evil, akusala, at that time, the many people can blame for us. Even the by myself also blaming. So. Now you only try. Who has the wise attention, wisdom? He can understand this is a blameful act. This one blameless act. Maybe that this way you can understand blameless and blameful and blameless state. And another one, inferior and superior state means the we can say hina panita. Actually, who has the bad quality? His life inferior, very bad. Who has the good quality? His life is a superior. Now, if someone want to be the superior life, if someone want to get the superior life, my means not they call the property. Who has the car? Who has the very good income? Who has the very good environment? Those are also superior, but according to Dhamma, we are calling not the property, according to the mind. Who is developing the good qualities? Those are people who are superior than others. And now this way, who has the wisdom, because of wisdom faculty and the investigating of the factor, can understand what is the inferior quality and superior quality. The another one is a dark and bright state with their counterparts. Now, this one also, dark and bright. Example, dark means that someone always doing bad action, bad verbal and bad mind action. Because of the his behavior is very bad. Because of that, his life will be dark. Okay, then who is doing the always wholesome? Someone practicing meditation and keeping morality and practicing concentration and the developing concentration and the whatever he doing the good thing wholesome, because of that his life become very bright. Now this way, who has the wisdom, those are people can understand clearly. This is the main fact, main condition to develop our investigating factor. Now this another, there are seven other conditions also explaining in the book. Actually this one also very important, because nowadays the many people very much like to develop our own wisdom, but someone doesn't know the way, someone know the way, but if someone doesn't know the way, this is a those are seven conditions, the way to develop our wisdom faculty or investigation faculty. Now the number one is paripuccha katha, means asking questions or discussing dhamma regarding aggregates, elements, sense bases, depending origination, and the patthana method, and the cause and effect method, and the whatever deep dhamma but regarding the ultimate reality, paramatta. Then who are going to discuss, who are going to ask in question and whatever, then because of that, because of this reason, you can increase your wisdom, you can increase your investigation faculty, the factor. Okay, that's about the meaning of the aggregates, elements, sense bases, etc. They explain also. The number two, vattu siddhi kiriyata, this one is very important. Personal cleanliness, making the internal bases, hair, nails, body, same way, and external bases, clothing, dwelling place, and everything must be clean. Now, if someone want to develop your panya, you should clean internal things and external things. Example, now the someone going to study dhamma in the to the meditation hall or dhamma hall, but dhamma hall very dirty, very messy. You should clean first before start the discussing. Why? After clean your room or in the dhamma hall, your place, dwelling place, then your mind very easy to get calm. Who has the calm and peaceful mind, then very easy to concentrate. Because of the concentrate, you can very easy to understand what you have heard, what you are going to study. That's why this one, because of the vattu siddhi kiriyata, is also very important to develop our wisdom. Number third, also very important, indriya samanta patipadanata, the balancing the faculties. Now we know there are how many faculties, the faith faculty, saddha indriya, energy faculty, viri indriya, sati indriya, mindfulness faculty, samadhi indriya, concentration faculty, panya indriya, wisdom faculty. Those are five faculties must balance when you are doing wholesome, when you are doing kusala, especially the example, now you want to listen to dhamma, you want to by heart dhamma, you want to practice dhamma, the every time the five faculties must be balanced with the wholesome object. Without unbalancing, difficult to develop your wisdom. Okay, this one is very important. Now the number fourth, the dupanya poggala parivajjanata, you should avoiding unwise people from your life. This was very important, because always you are going to associate the foolish people, foolish men, then always you can get the rubbish thing from them, the dirty thing, evil things. Then that's why you should avoid like these people from your life. and Panyavanta Pugara Sevanta, associating with the wise people. You should try to associate the wise people, the good person, who is keeping morality, who is practicing Dhamma, who is practicing meditation, and who is studying Dhamma, and who is sharing Dhamma. Try to associate those are the good person. This one also very, very important for us to develop our panya. Number the six also very important. Reflecting on the field of deep, profound knowledge of the Buddha. Not for us. This was Gambhira Jnana Chari Pachavekkanta is reflecting on the field of deep, profound knowledge of the Buddha. Our Buddha's knowledge. When you are reflecting the Buddha's knowledge, then you can penetrate by your mind. You can go and deep and deep. You can go inside. You can see the clearly. Very, very clearly you can see. This one also very important. Example, now we are always going to recite the omniscient knowledge, Sabbanyuta Jnana. Okay, now here they are, omniscient, Sabbanyuta, our Lord Buddha, Sabbanyuta, Sabbanyuta. But if you know the meaning of Sabbanyuta, very interesting, very, very interesting. According to the Patisambhida Magapali, the Bhante Sariputta explained what is the meaning of Sabbanyuta knowledge, omniscient knowledge. Sabbang sankata masankatang anavasesan janatiti Sabbanyuta Jnana. Means the all are sankata, all are conditions and unconditions. Things know very well. Our Lord Buddha knows the very well unconditioned conditions in the world. Because this is we call Sabbanyuta. And Atitan Sabban Janatiti Sabbanyuta Jnana. How about in the past? Whatever done in the past, whatever happened in the past, everything Lord Buddha knows. Anagatan Sabban Janatiti Sabbanyuta Jnana. Whatever happening will happen in the future, everything know. And Achupannan Sabban Janatiti Sabbanyuta Jnana. Whatever happening in the present, everything Lord Buddha know. This is because Sabbanyuta. This way, about faculty, aggregates, bases, faculties, everything depending origination, one by one, our Lord Buddha explained. So that's why if you know the you can understand the knowledge of the Buddha. You can reflect the deep knowledge of the Buddha. This one also one of the condition to develop our investigating as a factor. Number seven, resolution, tadajimuttata. Who has wish to develop wisdom? This is the meaning. Because without our wishes or without our mind, someone doesn't have mind. I want to develop. I want to the practice. And then difficult to get the to develop wisdom. That's why we need who has the wish. I want to develop the panya. Who has determination to develop the panya? This is resolution. So this way, now there are two investigating factor. We already explained the mindfulness and investigation the panya. Okay. Now number third is also important about the enlightenment factor of the effort, the energy virya. This one also frequently giving the wise attention to the element arousal in initial phase of energy. The energy to begin an activity. Now example. Now they are energy. Now we are going to energy in the virya. They are because of the yoniso manasikara can develop the virya. Without yoniso manasikara also cannot develop the virya. Now there are three types of virya. Arambha dhatu, the element of arousal. means the initial phase of energy. The energy is the beginning and activity. This is the beginning point of activity, beginning moment. Okay, beginning moment. The Nikkama Dhatu, they say the intermediate energy, the intermediate energy. Parakkama Dhatu, the element of the exertion, energy, the full intensity. Intensity in still stronger than anyway. There are three types of virya explaining in the book. The beginning, begin of activity, and intermediate activity, and after fulling. The from beginning until end, you have to keep your energy continuously the same level, same level. This is a vigo energy. But anyway, sometime. Difficult to keep our energy same level. Sometimes very easy to weak. Sometimes fell down from the energy. Now, how we develop our energy? There are 11 other conditions in the commentary explain. Apai bhai pachavekkanatta. You should reflecting on the fearful of woeful place. Now you know about the apaya. There are four types of woeful place, no? Because the who are going to apaya, who committed evil or akusala karma, because of that he can reborn in the one of the woeful place. Same way, you should try to reflecting on the fearfulness of the plane of the woeful place, such as hell being, and ghost, and the hungry ghost, and asura, and same animals. There are many the different type of hell. After you reflect in the fearfulness of the woeful place, then automatic energy arising. Then because we are also very fear to go to the hell. We are very fear to reborn in the one of the woeful place. Then if you want to get the free from the woeful place life, you should accumulate wholesome, try to develop your virya. The same way, anisansa dasa vita, seeing the benefits of the energy, because now you see some people after developing their energy, they can reach to first dhyana level. Same way, second dhyana level, third, fourth, and eighth attainment. They can complete the all vipassana. Someone can enter the sotapatti. Someone can enter the sakadagami, anagami, arahat. Because of the energy. Then he has the strong energy. Because of the energy, he can develop his mind step by step, step by step. Then you should try to reflect the see the benefit of the energy. That's why anisansa, the benefit of the energy, you should reflect again and again, again and again. This one also one of the condition. Number third, they say gamana viti pachavekkanata. This one especially for the bhikkhus, especially for the bhikkhus. Reflecting that one is following the path taken by all the Buddha pachayeka Buddha and the great disciples, and his path cannot be taken by one who's idle. Means the actually the especially not only sorry not only because everyone gamana viti pachavekkanata, because the if someone want to be the samma sambuddha, if someone want to be the pachayeka Buddha, if someone want to be the great disciple, great arahat, then they are continuously developing the parami. They are continuously practicing parami. There one example. After the passed away Bhante Sariputta, then our Lord Buddha recite one gatha about the Bhante Sariputta. Yo pabbaji jati sattani pancha pahaya kamani manoramani tang vita ragam susamahitindriyam parinibhutam vandata sariputta. Now, Bhantisariputta, he get enlightened this life. Then he continuously 500 lives. He practiced the monks. He became the monk. He practiced going forth life. Continuously 500 life until this moment. Now you see, now the same way Bhante Mahamoggallana also. Same Bhante Mahakasapa. That's why we have to reflect their energy. They have a good strong energy because they are practiced the normal life, no? The very spiritual life continuously to get the arahatship now. The same way our Lord Buddha also practice Dhamma. How many asanke, how many kappa, you know, then you should refer the way sometime when you are practicing meditation, easy to continuously sit 1 hour, 2 hours. So difficult to concentrate, difficult to keep mindfulness, and very easy to mind go out, very easy to fall down from the meditation object. And all the time, you should try to refer it to our Buddha's way, our Pachika Buddha's way, and Ved Arhat way. After you're reflecting, you are automatically the energetical mind arising. The mind energy is arising. Then number fourth also, the reflect the Pindapathapa Chayanata, especially this one for the monk. That's why. This one only for the monk. The Pindapathapa Chayanata is the reflecting on the need to honor to gift of alms by producing great fruits for the donor. This one, especially the bhikkhu, the must reflect, because when you are going to Pindapatha, and many people going to offer the food, at that time, you should keep good behavior, good morality. Because why? Who is the producing the food for us? Maybe many donors. Those are people, not our relatives. Those are not our disciples, not our the relatives, or not our brothers and sisters. But all are offering food. They have the faith for us. Because of that, they are offering. Then bhikkhu must help for them to get the good benefit. The one example, in the ancient time, the one of the bhikkhu in Sri Lanka, one of the bhikkhu stay in the one of the hill, in the cave of the hill. He's practicing meditation diligently. One day he every day he come to Pindapatha line. They have the bottom of the mountain, they had one house. Actually, that one mother and one daughters are living that house. They are very poor, very poor. But anyway, every day this family offering the food for the bhikkhu, one day that bhikkhu came Pindapatha little earlier. Then on the way, he listened some sound from the mothers giving advice for the daughter. Dear daughter, today also the Bhante is coming Pindapatha. You should prepare the good food for the Bhante. Especially they have the ghee, they have the good rice, and they have the coconut. You make the milk rice with the ghee only for the Bhantes, and remaining thing you should eat, but don't make for me enough for me some porridge, with porridge. But actually they are very poor, no enough food to provide for the everyone. But mother told to the daughter, you should cook some special rice for the milk rice for the Bhante, and you also eat. Don't make for me. Now you see. Then after listening this sound, then bhikkhu got upset. Oh, those are the donors, not my mother, not my sisters, not my relatives. Why they are offering me the good food, good thing? Because they are belief. I have the good morality. I have the good concentration. I have the good behavior. But still that monk Putujjana, not the noble. Then that Bhikkhu returned to the, again, the cave. Today I don't want to go Pindapatha. He returned back to the cave. Then he start to reflect. After he ordained everything, he reflect. Then he concentrate. Then slowly he keep determined. Today I am going to sit and to meditate until arahatship. I never rose of the sitting. I don't want to get up the sitting. I want to continuously practice Dhamma until noble path. Then he has strong determination. Strongly determined his practice. Then continuously meditate. Yes. Then within the few hours before the noon time, he already get the arahatship. Then day after that, he found the time. Or still have the time. But actually, he found time. He checked it according to the sun. No? He checked the time. Then still have the time to go Pindapatha. He count up Pindapatha. Then that the lady, the daughter of the lady, she offered the food and looked like very handsome and very calm, very peaceful, better than before. Then she bowed down, and that the same day evening, the mother came to the house. The first question, the mother's first question, mother, daughter, did you offer food for our Bhante? Yes. Did you see any different the face today? Different? Yes, mother. Today's our Bhante is very, very beautiful, very handsome, and very clean. Maybe today he already get the some noble. He already became the noble. Then mother, bow down, lie down for that side and pay respect. Now you see, this way the bhikkhu must think about the donor. If you not think about the donor, difficult to develop Dhamma. If you should, the every bhikkhu must think about the donors, the offering, because they are hardworking, they are difficult to earn the money, but they have a lot of faith for the Sangha, for the us. That's why they are offering again and again, again and again. This way, the bhikkhu must reflect the about the Pindapatha. Now this is also the one good condition. Number five, also explaining Sattu Mahanta Pachavekkanata, reflecting on the greatness of the master. Because now you see, there are many teachers in the world. During the Buddha's time also, many of the ascetic monk, Brahmin, and the different kind of the ascetic teachers, no? But the Buddha is higher than all the teachers in the world. Now, you have to think, you have to reflect about our teacher's quality, the master's quality. Then the unsurpassable dispensation, that's the so helpful to us to honor it in the energetical, not otherwise. Because now, after we are reflecting our guest master, then we can easy to develop, increase our energetic. Next one, Sabrahmachari Mahanta Pachavekkanata, reflecting on the greatness of the heritage, inheritance. Example, now the heritage means we don't have any heritage, but we have only Dhamma heritage. And we have the Dhamma teachers. Example, our Lord Buddha's great disciple, Bhante Maha Sariputta, Maha Moggallana, Maha Kassapa, etc. Then when we are reflecting, those are the teachers, those are the good, the people's good, the arahat, the qualities, then very easy to develop our energy. The number seven, removing sloth and torpor by paying attention to the perception of light, changing posture, frequenting open space. Now this one also, because when you are meditating, you should meditate in the light, with the light. in the open area. And the same way, the you try to use the suitable posture. But this way you can develop your energy. Number 8, avoiding lazy people. The kusita poggala parivarjanata. You don't associate the lazy person, lazy man. Number 9, associating with energetic people who has a strong virya, who has the strong energy to develop dhamma. You should try to associate by this good person. This is very important and very good. The same way, the another thing, the reflecting on the right striving, sammapayoga. They say the anuppannānaṁva kusalānandam, anuppannānaṁva akusalānandammānaṁ anupādāya. Uppannānaṁva akusalānandammānaṁ bahānāya. Anuppannānaṁva kusalānandammānaṁ upādāya. Uppannānaṁva kusalānandammānaṁ bhiyo bhāvāya. The meaning, generated desire for the non-arising of unarisen evil, unwholesome state. He makes an effort, arouse energy, apply his mind and strives. Same way, generates desire for the abounding of arisen evil, unwholesome state. Same way, arising of unarisen wholesome state. Maintenance of arisen wholesome state. Now this way, we are always, when we are doing the good kusala, at that time, we can, there are four meaning, unarisen wholesome to, so unarisen unwholesome to unarise, arisen wholesome to destroy, and unarisen evil unwholesome to unarise. And arisen wholesome to destroy. Unarisen wholesome to arise and arisen wholesome to develop, the maintains. This way, the example, now someone offering dana. When you're offering dana, always you keep the good mind. Then the dana moment, the dana offering moment, you are keeping good mind, because you have a good pure mind. This is my offering. I'm going to offer to the Sangha. After offering, I can get the good benefit. This way, the unarisen wholesome to arising. And same way, arisen wholesome, then the maintenance of the arisen wholesome state. This way, we can develop our virya energy. Next one. Also tadiddhi muttata, right, resolution, means the who has the strong determination to develop energy. This way our Lord Buddha explained there are 7 enlightenment factors. Now we already study the but mindfulness, the same way investigation and the energy factor of the enlightenment. Because these 3 factors also very important to develop our meditation, and especially to maintain our meditation object. Sati and mindfulness and wisdom always working together with the meditation object. In the same moment, virya, giving the energy, giving the energy to protect the object, because if no energy, means very easy to fall down from the meditation object, very easy to arise the wandering thoughts to disturb our meditation object. That's why these 3 enlightenment factors, you should work together with the meditation object. At that time, you can slowly increase your concentration up to jhana level, or up to attainment, up to vipassana, up to the noble path and frozen knowledge. Today also I am explaining only the time, it's only the three factors. Tomorrow I can continue. They have another four enlightenment factors about the piti, pasaddi, samadhi, and upekkha. This one also important to us to know the with detail to develop our dhamma and experience. Today also we study about the enlightenment some factors. After listening those are dhamma, we also accumulate the very good wholesome giving dhamma and listening. After listening dhamma, the both of us already accumulate the very great wholesomes. Our Lord Buddha explained the dhamma dana. This is the offering, the gift of the dhamma. We are giving the we are doing the dhamma dana wholesome. Big power of the dhamma dana kusala support to us to get a good life and a healthy life. And may all of you be healthy, and may all of you be well and happy. May all of you be free from all suffering, especially the nowadays they have the difficult period for us because of the coronavirus attack with the human beings. But we have to keep a strong mind after practicing this dhamma, after developing our this dhamma, avoid this coronavirus from not only from our life, not only from our country, from all the world. All the as soon as the we have to keep the good wish and keep good determine. May all of you be free for all suffering and attain Nibbana soon. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Bhante, there's a question. Bhante, may I know who is King Chakravarti? There's one question
on the chat. The Chakravarti is the universal king. The universal king means he's a king of the whole the world. Whole the world. He has the very good the power of the mind, and he has the very beautiful, the handsome body, because now you know about our Lord Buddha, so they had the 32 the body factor, the anga. The same way the king universe also have the perfect body, the very just like the Buddha, and he can fly the sky. And he can go to the Deva world also. And he can stay Deva world. He can discuss with the Deva. And he can hunger come down. And during that period, no any evil things in the world. People never ever do any evil thing. Never commit any akusala karma. Never break any one of the panchasila. So they always keeping good behavior. Always practicing keeping sila, and at that time no any difficulties appear in the world, no harming or no any unhuman beings not attack, no any different illness like coronavirus, like this is not appearing. Very calm and very peaceful period, the king universal time. Another thing, the two king cannot appear together in the one place. Okay, together cannot appear. The whole the world appear only one king. But during that period, the maybe some Buddha can appear, because my maybe means the in the past they have history. Our Bodhisattva also the one of the king during the one of the Buddha's time. Universal king. In the universal king period, the two universal king can appear together. Sometime the during the Buddha's period can appear one of the universal king, but this is very rare. This is my meaning, very rare. this way we have to understand about the universe king. If you want to know much detail about that, you can go in to check one sutta, Lakkhana Sutta. Lakkhana Sutta is coming from the Digha Nikaya. That sutta also explaining about the 32, the body Lakkhana, the characteristic of the 32 body. This one also we can understand. Okay.
Okay. Hi Bhante, is it compulsory to know and understand the 7 or 37 factors of enlightenment before one can attain jhana absorption?
Thank you. Actually, Bhante. Especially the 7 enlightenment factors and but all are need to know to practice when you're practicing Dhamma, especially 5 faculties and 7 enlightenment factors. Very much important to know when you are practicing meditation.
Hello, Bhante.
Yes.
Hello. The 7 factors of enlightenment is about how one could progress from the practice, right?
Actually, the
based
7
the factors described. Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, there are 7 factors. One by one, if you know the meaning, actually those are factors arising together in the same one mind. In the one mind, the 7 factors arising together in the one mind, because they are mental factors, chetasika. Yeah, sati, yes. Ola, set chetasika arising together with the wholesome mind. Okay,
but the, I asked that question. Sorry. It supposed to arise together or in a certain sequence? I ask this question because one of the 7 factors is equanimity, which I know is something very difficult to achieve until one reach a certain stage.
Yeah. Actually, the equanimity is upekkha. This equanimity we are called the one chetasika. It's tatra majjatata, one chetasika. This is not the equanimity feeling. Okay, those are some factors arising among the 7 factors. Sometime arising together, some of factors. Because the example. Sati sometimes is stronger than other factors. At that time, we can feel only sati. Sometimes, investigate factors higher than, stronger than others. At that time, we can feel the investigate factors. That's why those are 7 factors. Sometimes, we can feel the separately. But actually, when the sati arising, at that time, mindfulness or the sometimes wisdom arises. Sometimes not no wisdom, because you know the some wholesome, wisdomful wholesome, some wisdom, some mind unwisdomful, some kusala sometimes have wisdom, some don't have wisdom, but the mindfulness arises with the wisdom mind. At that time, mindfulness and wisdom very strong. Sometimes the mindfulness arising without wisdom. At that time, wisdom very weak, no wisdom. The mindfulness also very weak. The according to the Abhidhamma, we have to understand those are 7 factors are chetasika, mental factors. Okay? Those are mental factors arising with the consciousness. Now, we try to balance those are factors together with the meditation object. To the when you are doing the wholesome kusala, try to balance together. But the especially the equanimity, quite different factors with others, and the PT also. Different with others. Why? The sometimes the PT not arising. In the upekkha, the sometimes upekkha wholesome arising, no? The upekkha wholesome moment, piti also not arising, not joined together, not arising. That's why we have to understand the seven factors. All are seven factors not arising together, but sometimes some of factors arising together. But according to our way, according to the example, sometimes the mindfulness higher than others, sometimes the wisdom higher than others, sometimes virya higher than others, sometimes other factors are higher than others. But we have to balance according to the Abhidhamma. Sorry, do you understand?
I think so. Sadhu, oh. Sadhu, sadhu.
Yes, Bhante, does the counterpart sign need to be maintained long enough to get into the jhana as option?
Of course. Because the counterpart, the counterpart is the parikarma samadhi, no? Parikarma samadhi. The nimitta. Yeah, we have to maintain. But yes, patibhaga nimitta, yeah. Patibhaga nimitta, we have to maintain long enough to get the jhana, of course. Because without maintain the patibhaga nimitta, you cannot enter the jhana. But there are two types of jhana, no? The jhana and attainment. The jhana consciousness and attainment consciousness. There are two, the way. Counterparts and patibhaga nimitta.
Bhante, I asked a question. Just now Bhante mentioned that these seven factors are related to Chetasika. So can Bhante let us know, like, of mindfulness is sati, is that correct? So each one is related to which Chetasika?
Mindfulness is sati, it's a sati Chetasika. Dhamma vichaya, investigative factor is panya. And the virya energy, enlightened factor of the energy is virya sambojja, it's called virya. And the piti sambojjanga, which is an enlightened factor of the rapture, piti, we call piti chetasika. The same way the passadhi, also passadhi chetasika. They have the two passadhi, kaya passadhi, chitta passadhi. Kaya is a body tranquilly and mind tranquilly. Body is called the three aggregates, Vedana, Sanya, Sankara. They are tranquilly of the three aggregates, which is called Kaya Passadhi. The mind, the tranquilly of the mind aggregates, we call Chitta Passadhi. And the Samadhi is a concentration, this is Ekagata, one pointness, Chetasika Ekagata. And the upekkha sambojjanga, it's called not the upekkha, tatra majjatata. Tatra majjatata, to the balancing of the faculties. It's in this tatra majjatata. This is each factors, they have each enlightenment, they have the chetasika. This is their seven chetasika. And now the sati always arises with the beautiful mind. And the wisdom arises with the wisdomful mind. And the virya arising with the, except the, I think the 10 vijnana and the Fido adverting consciousness and the investigating, there are two of investigating except dosa consciousness arising vidya with others. Piti always arising with the sukha, internal happiness mind, the somanasam mind. Passadhi always arising with the wholesome mind, the beautiful mind. This way, and the samadhi arises with every mind movement, but we have to understand which samadhi is right, which samadhi is bad. good and bad, right and wrong. And the upekkha, tatra madhyata also arises with the beautiful mind.
Thank you, Panti. Okay, any other questions from the audience? Anyone have any question, you can type on the chat or raise up your hand or on the mic and ask Panti. Okay, if there's no other questions, Panti, we can share merit. Any other questions? Yeah, you can. Okay, thank you, Panti. Panti.
Yes, repeat after me. Idam me punyang asavakkaya vahang hotu. Idam me punyang nibbanasa pachayo hotu. Mama punya bhagang sabba sattanang bhajemi. Te sabbe me samang punya bhagang labhantu sadhu sadhu sadhu.